So you're here because you want to take your HUD effects with LumiStream just that little bit further. There is a warning, it could break things. Now, not only that you can have multiple HUD effects everywhere, you can also just have one, two, three, how many ever you think that you want. And you can also just have a HUD effects over your camera. So these are little workarounds just to make your streams a little bit, maybe we can say better, at least funnier for your viewers, if not you. And what we mean is things like this. You get the idea of what you could do with HUD effects. So instead of just having one thing across your main screen, you can have multiple versions across your main screen. Now remember, HUD effects reacts on your game screen as well. So what the viewers can see, you're seeing directly on your game monitor. Or you can choose different monitors if you've got different monitors and they can play on that. But where's the fun in that? And then you can not have it on your monitors at all. You can just use an overlay, which will mean it'll just play on your OBS so just your viewers can see it. So how do we go about this then? Well, that's what we're here for. I'm going to show you how to break things. Just don't go run into the devs and say, look, the Mad Rambo showed me how to do this, told me I could do this, told me I should do this. He broke it. Can you fix it, please? Because the devs will just come to me and start shouting at me and I might have to go in the corner and cry. So we already know how to use LumiStream, I'm guessing. If not, we have plenty of guide videos on my YouTube. So go take a look. To start off with, we need to go into overlays on your LumiStream. So we'll click overlays. These are all the overlays I've got, so we'll create a new overlay and we'll just call this test 2 because I've already got a test running at the moment. So we'll add new overlay and we want to add a layer. So top left, add layer, and then we want to go to HUD effects, HUD effects video. Awesome. Now what I do for ease is, well, we will go to the top right and we'll go to the layer name and we'll change the layer name because this is how you're going to find what HUD effects to put on which layer later on in the video. We'll name this one left. Brilliant. We will bring that down. We'll add another layer and we'll name this one middle. Brilliant. And then we'll add another one, a third one, and we'll name this one right. So now I know exactly where these are when I am choosing where to put my HUD effects. Now you can put as many as you want on, you can name them exactly what you want, but for ease, for me, this is what I choose. Then we want to go to save, which is in top right. Brilliant, overlay saved. We will close this down. So that overlay is finished. So we know it's, the overlay is called test 2. That's what we'll need to know. What we're going to do as well, we're going to open this as a HUD and we're going to click open. We know this is my main screen, but if you wanted to choose another screen, you can choose your other screen. Now I'm running four screens on this machine. Brilliant. Now we're going to go into HUD effects. Let's find some HUD effects. So we'll send you to Jesus. Brilliant. We'll use it as a Twitch point command. You can change the name, the volume, how many points it takes on here. Now I'm using a secret version. I'm not 100% sure that you've got this option when selecting the HUD effects. So I'll take you through this option and I'll take you through the legacy option as well, because, well, when you are trying to change your HUD effects, you're going to need to know that legacy option anyway. So when you've chose your HUD effects, you can go to advanced overlay. So this is going to be, well, which overlay in your Lumia is your HUD effects on? So we know it's on test 2. That's what we've just created. And then layer, we're going to choose this one as the right one. Done. So we press refresh, and now if we test this one,
I will send you to Jesus.
So we can see that played on the right. Awesome. Now we go back into our HUD effects and then we'll choose a different one. Let's take this one. So click use. We're going to put it in a channel point. We want it on test 2 and then we want this on the left. Done. Refresh. Everything you do, you need to refresh. And then we will take this one, channel point, advanced, test 2, layer, and we want this one in the middle. Brilliant, refresh. So now, if we test them all, the middle where we've set it, on the left, and of course,
I will send you
on the right. So now we have just learned how to separate your HUD effects, where to place them on your screen, if you want them on different parts of your screen. Maybe you are always playing a certain type of game that you want a HUD effects to cover that part of the game, so your viewers can mess with your game as such because you can't see what you're doing on that game. If we go into our commands now, and we go to Twitch points. Now I know it's the top three because I've not grouped them or anything. Now I'm going to say I want this top one to play on all of them. So we're going into edit. So this is what I mean about the legacy commands. And if you want to be able to change anything. So we'll go to the edit button, which is the pen. We go into HFX and we will empty the selection and we'll click apply, refresh.
Nice.
As you can see, now it's played across all of them. So as you can see there, we went into the command where the HUD effects is, pressed edit, went into HFX, and we removed the overlay, which removes the layers. So what that means is the HUD that you have open, it will now play across all of those layers on the HUD overlay that you've got open. So we can show you again, we'll test it.
Nice.
Now, maybe you've got loads of HUD effects. Maybe you don't want them to be able to play all the time. You can turn them off with the state function here. This will mean no one will be able to redeem this in your channel points. And you can also go back into your overlays and open up a different HUD. Now, if we go back in and test the original one that we've just been doing, the nice one, though we've just tried to activate it, nothing happens because I don't have the test 2 open as the HUD. I have got my original HUD, which is this one. Now, I originally had all of these coming up as little layers on the HUD because I was doing a different video and I left them on for stream because I couldn't be bothered to change them and my stream had a field day with it. Now, for some reason, they all do have a slight delay on. I don't know why. Maybe one of the devs one day can tell me why. Doing this sometimes can sometimes cause Lumia Stream to crash. This is the only way I've ever managed to get Lumia Stream to crash. Now, I'm going to show you how to use a HUD effects without using a HUD. So just using an overlay, which then you will be able to put the HUD effects over your camera. Because if you're using the HUD effects with the HUD open, you will need to be capturing OBS, your footage, through a display capture, not a game capture, because it has to read what's coming on the display, right? But if it's, obviously, if you're using a camera, your camera's got to be a of in seeding order of your display capture. Otherwise, no one's going to be able to see your camera. So that means your HUD effects would never be able to go over your camera. We have a workaround. The workaround is using a browser source. So we're going to add a new overlay. We're going to call this test 3. Leave this as 1080p because it's only going to go over my camera. Brilliant. Add a layer. HUD effects video. For simple reasons, we're going to call this camera. Brilliant. We're going to copy the URL. So top right, copy URL. URL copied to clipboard. And we are going to add this onto my OBS sources. So there's lots of me, but if you're unsure how to do this, we'll show you now. So press the plus button on your sources, browser. We'll call this HUDFX cam. Okay. We've just copied that. So with control V, we'll paste it in. We want it the same resolution as our HUDFX overlay on Lumia, 1920 by 1080. That's what it's set to. Press OK. And it's here. We're going to scale it down. I nearly lost my mouse because there's so many of me. Brilliant. Press save. Overlay saved. Press the X button. Go to dashboard. Now we are going to go into HUDFX. We are going to choose another one. Let's choose the laughing bird. So we're going to press use. We use this as a channel point command again. Advanced overlay. We want this on test 3 now. Layer. We want this cam. Done. Brilliant. Refresh. Now if we go and test it, laughing red burb, redeem. As you can see, so it didn't come up on my main monitor. It won't affect what I see on stream, what I see on when I'm gaming, but everyone who's in the chat can see it. So you could use this for what I used to use as a drink command, have water coming across. You can use that for anything you can think of that would be good to cover your camera. We can use that. And you can have multiple of these, multiple overlays of these. It'll all work the same. You'll also have to be careful. If you're used, it doesn't matter which HUD you are using. So as you can see, I've got three. So we've got HUD, we've got test two and test three. Both, all three of these are my HUD overlays. I can flick and choose between them. We've just created the two test ones, right? But if you choose a HFX and you allow it to play across all three of these. So for instance, test two, if we go back into our command, if we go Twitch points, and if we go the nice one, we go into edit. HFX, we know it's on test two anyway, so we'll empty selection, apply. So this one will play across right, middle, and left. But because we've set up a browser source, this will also pick up that. It doesn't matter if your browser source is on a different overlay within Lumia, it'll still play across it. So if we go into the command, into the Twitch points, and we click this to test it, you'll see exactly what I mean.
Nice.
So you can see, so the browser source that we set up, even though it's on a different overlay within Lumia Stream, it will still play on your browser source in OBS. Simple way to get rid of that. If you want your HFX to play on multiple different points of your screen, it's just make it invisible. So we can also do something a little bit different with your HUD effects as well. So not only that, you can use them with Twitch points, Twitch extension, which puts a panel in your Twitch for people to be able to redeem one of your HUD effects or light change, anything like that, and you could charge bits for. You've also got chat commands, which traditionally always need an exclamation mark. What you can do, say you want to choose this one that says hello, is press use. We'll use it as a chat command. Obi-Wan, hello, that's fine. That'll be the command for it. I want to put this on HUD because this is what I'm using right now, and we'll use this as HFX video one. Done. Brilliant. Refresh. We'll go into the commands, chat commands. Here it is, the top one that we've just made. We'll go into the edit part, and we'll go to aliases. Now, what aliases do, so people don't have to type in the exclamation mark. So if we type hello, enter, so we can see it there, apply, refresh. If we bring up the chat and someone comes into your Twitch channel while you're live and says hello Rambo,
hello there.
So as you can see, that HUD effect is just triggered off someone saying hello. So we use this for KekW, Cat Jam, just to make our stream a little bit more interactive. Sometimes people don't realize, well, how did that come up? I've never seen that before. It's a talking point. But we can also go into the chat bot and we can say, we can disable or enable it, and we can just say welcome, apply, refresh. So if we bring that up so you can see exactly what happens, so someone says hello,
hello there,
and you can see it says Mad Rambo, welcome. So these are the other things that we can do with HUD effects. One more thing that we could do is maybe you want to have two different HUD effects coming up at the same time, but only maybe using one chat command, one alias, one extension, or one channel point. We could go into, say, I will send you to Jesus, go into overlay action. The type, we scroll down, we want to send HUD effects. The overlay, so where do you want this to come up on? So we can go, say, test two, we'll go middle. What HUD effects do you want to happen? We'll go damage, add action, apply, refresh. So now when someone presses your channel point, I will send you to Jesus.
I will send you to Jesus.
Oh, we've got two different HUD effects coming up at the same time in two different locations. Think of the possibilities you can do with that. Maybe you've already got some HUD effects in mind that you'd want to upload, or maybe you found some on Lumia or the HUD effects website that you want to use already, and you can tie them all into the same thing. And this is the power of Lumia Stream. Near enough, your imagination is the end goal. What you can think of you can probably do. If you can't do, there's a workaround. But one caveat with all of this is if you create multiple layers for your HUD effects and you've already got HUD effects set up on your Twitch for people to pick from, to choose, to play, you will need to go into these and set where you want them to go. Otherwise, they will play everywhere. Yes, everywhere. Now, it was fun for a stream, but I'm going to have to go through all of mine and redo all of mine. But I hope this helped you out. I hope you can get a bit more fun from your HUD effects from Lumia stream. If you've got any questions, please do ask either myself, go into the comments, jump into the Lumia stream's Discord. There's plenty of people out there that will help, including the staff. Like I said before, break things. It's not my fault. Hope you enjoyed this video. I've been the Mad Rambo and I will catch you in the next video.